Welcome back to Relax My Dog. I'm Barbara, and today we're going to look at short-haired versus long-haired dogs. If there's a preference that you have, do pop it in the comments below. We'd love to hear about it after you watch this video. And first of all, I'm going to pass you over to Lucy, who's going to announce the winner of our trick competition.
Everybody, we're just popping in to announce the winners of the pawlympics. We are so excited to announce this. We had so many amazing entries, so many good videos of super talented doggies. We absolutely loved looking at them all, but of course there could only be one winner, and that's what we're here to announce today. Who's the winner? So the winner is Mighty Mika on Instagram. So we absolutely love this video. This dog is so clever. Look how many tricks she can do. She is so talented. We just loved this video as soon as we saw it. She actually reminds me a lot of Taff, my little co-star. He absolutely loves doing tricks, and you can tell that this dog loves it as well. She's having the absolute best time, and it is so amazing to see. We love this video. So well done, Mika. You have won our Derek and Co box and a little trophy. Yay! So we had so many entries that we actually wanted to do a little honorary mention to Brianna Heiser. Look at this video, it's so cute. Look how high this dog jumps. It's so lovely to see. She's having such a good time. So well done, Mika. You are gonna be the winner of our lovely prizes over here. And be sure to stay tuned to the Relax My Dog channel, because I'm sure we're gonna be doing loads more competitions and giveaways soon. So stay tuned. Okay, see ya.
Back to short-haired versus long-haired dogs, here are some things to consider if you are trying to decide between the two. First of all, there's grooming. Obviously, long-haired dogs will require a bit more regular grooming, although both short-haired and long-haired dogs need regular brushing to avoid their fur getting matted. Some long-haired dogs have parted coats where you need to not only brush their hair but part it as well, and often you have to trim their facial hair, which otherwise could fall into their eyes. Short-haired dogs still need to be groomed, however, and dogs with tight, curly hair in particular definitely need regular grooming and bathing. Next, there's shedding. Both long-haired and short-haired dogs do shed, although with long-haired dogs it tends to be more seasonal, whereas short-haired dogs tend to shed throughout the year. The only dogs who don't shed are the hairless breeds, of which there are a few, such as the American Hairless Terrier or the Chinese Crested Dog. But these dogs actually require more maintenance with moisturizer, as their skin can become quite dry. And no matter how long your dog's hair is, nail clipping is still a necessity, as well as trimming the hair in between their toes and cleaning their ears. Next, there's cleaning up the hair that they do shed. You might think it's easier to clean up hair from a short-haired dog, but actually owners say that it's more difficult to vacuum it up, as it can work its way more easily into furnishings and carpets than long hair. Next, there's dealing with extreme temperatures. Long-haired dogs can have a bit more of a hard time when it's very warm outside, because they have all that extra fur to contend with. This means at the height of summer, you might want to keep them indoors during the heat of the afternoon, and perhaps walk them either early in the morning or in the evening, as otherwise they could get overwhelmed with the heat. Having said that, in colder climates, the extra fur serves them well, of course, to keep them warm. Short-haired dogs might do better in hot weather, but they might need a little coat when it's cold outside. So you may want to consider the weather in your area. So what's your opinion about long-haired dogs versus short-haired dogs? Do pop it in the comments below. We'd love to hear about it. And if you've enjoyed this video, please do give it a thumbs up. It helps the channel a lot. And if you haven't yet subscribed, you can do that by clicking on the button in the middle. And while you're there, you can hop on over to the far side to check out one of our previous vlog videos. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you soon in another video. Bye for now.